Hey everyone, so Maddie and I are doing a little road trip up to Lightning Ridge. So stay tuned over the next few days. We're going to post some little videos, do some drone flying, capture all the windmills and silos and water tanks that are all painted up. We're going to hit the Groen piles, which are dump sites for overburden when they dig out the opal mines. They truck it in, they dump it in this massive pile. There's three around each other, and they're about the size of a footy field each. By law, they're not allowed to actually dump it around the area. It has to be at these designated sites. Then the council get it back and use it for road base. So we're going to hit the black lights, get them all out, and go searching at dusk in the big piles for opal. See how we go. And first stop is Gunnedah, 4 hours away. Then we're going to have some dinner there, camp out, film the first silo, and we'll do a live stream later on tonight from up at Gunnedah. All right, stay tuned. Catch ya. And here's the Hunter Valley power station group. So there's a big power station on the left. I think it's got two big units. So you have four monster cooling stacks and the two heater stacks there, you can see. And then, and that's Maddie. And on the right hand side, there's another power station. But yeah, there's that big beast on the left hand side. I don't think you can see it from there, but when we get to the top of the hill, let's see if we can pan over.
Shall we begin?
This is the awesome town of Aberdeen, where they hold the Highland Games. I think it's the first Saturday of July, August. And they have, all the old pole throwing competitions and hurling, and you all get to dress in tartan. I don't know what they grow here, but there's a lot of crops on the left and right hand sides. If anyone knows where they grow in Aberdeen, leave it down in the comments below. All right, better catch up to Maddie and get some time lapse going on. That was Aberdeen. This is the new Scone bypass. So you completely miss Scone, the horse capital of Australia. And bypass it. We don't get to see any horses. Just this awesome mountain range and sky coming up. Check out that. So we're trying to get set up camp in Gunnedah before nightfall. So we're going to go shoot on site, then make it down to the campground on the river. About to leave Scone. It comes out about 3.5k. Murawara's got a nice silo that's painted up too. But it's 50k out of the way, so we'll miss that one. But there's a little town up here called Wingen. And I'll do a time lapse through there. And the mountain range is awesome. Really sharp little mountains right on the edge of the horizon. You can see it, they get really pointy. So you can imagine a 50, 60 meter high mountain to the size of a footy oval. So they're pretty intense to walk through. And there's like 12 or 15 of these little things on the right hand side. Looks pretty awesome. Leaving the horse. horse capital of Australia, Scone. So if you're right-hand side up here, you'll see all these mountains that just pop up from nowhere. Video won't do it justice, but this one here in front, man, you couldn't walk up it. They're just like pyramids. There's another one over in the distance. Look at that, straight up. And they get a lot steeper than that and really close together. We'll just catch up to Maddie here. Wingen's two to three hundred meters ahead of us here. Just get through here before this lane shuts off. Go on, Maddie, give it some stick. There we go. Look at this one here. And up through the back there, you can just see heaps of these little mountains. All right, that's Wingen. Check it out next time you're coming through. There's an antique shop, camping ground, a pub. Here's the hotel. Hotel on your left. Camp down by the creek. There's a few camping places through here and antique stores. All right, let's get back to it. It's a coal seam that's been smoking away for a few years. There's the turn off there. Burning Mountain Rest Area, National Park. Google Leyland Brothers. They went to it in the 70s. There's a YouTube video all about it. I'm sure someone's made another one. But yeah, Burning Mountain, cool place to stop off. Better on a rainy day, so you get a lot more steam and stuff coming out of the cracks. All right, it's Burning Mountain. Now, on the main trip all the way here, this is one of the speed cameras left. Drops down to a 70 zone. And it's all horse stud area. Amazing. And they give you plenty of warning. You go over a bridge that splits here. Pages River. Cross that. And the speed camera's just up ahead here. On your left. This is all horse stud area here. Seen a lot of eagles and owls on the road. A few chickens. It's Rothmans or something. Let's have a look. Emirates. Emirates Park. So they own all of this area here. That's why it's in pretty smick condition. And either side of the road's just paddocks with horse stables. It goes for about 6 km's. see one horse. Pages River again wraps back around, and then you go up here to the left, and that's Marundi, the town. It's got about 15 shops, a few parks, lots of antique shops, a little bit of camping by the river. The whole joint's surrounded by those two massive mountain ranges. That's enough about Marundi. Let's hyperlapse. This is Marundi's main street. The White Hart Hotel's about the biggest thing here. 5 o'clock and everything's completely shut. Pages River again, and the station's just down there. And that's pretty much it. We leave Marundi. Got all the steam engines and memorial stuff on the left hand side. It's got like big tractors and traction engines, and there's a bowling club on the left too. And a Chinese restaurant and a little school. That's about it. And your fuel for $1.09, diesel for $1.14, and that's Marundi.
Last night we flying 0 hours 9 a.m.
Tree. It's one of the towns where I've come up for holidays. Look at these things overhead. They're like twirly things on the wires. They're only in Willow Tree. I haven't seen them anywhere else. They're like spinners. Here comes a group. You know, they're everywhere, on every wire. I don't know if it's a bird thing, but this is Willow Tree. So we'll catch a train up from the Central Coast here every school holidays to Eric and Marjorie Barwick. They lived on the farm, and then my relos are in the Bowleys, and Clarks are in Corindai, which is just north of up here. So Willow Tree. Can you believe once when I was 14, me and a mate, middle of summer walk from here, Willow Tree Station, about 15k back south up to the mountains to the farm, and it was that, I think it might have been year 2000, whenever that war was about to happen with Iraq, and you know, they played the final countdown and all that business, we're worried about Scud missiles and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, that was a big hike. Took us a few hours, and we had to drink out of creeks. But here's all Willow Tree now. It's just all art stuff. Left and right hand side, there's just art. There's the Kokoda Memorial there on the right hand side, and then we leave Willow Tree. There's a sign for it on the right hand side. Come back soon. We go up here. We veer left out towards Gunnedah. Corindai, where Nan lives, is 15 minutes on the left. All right, catch up. This is part of Gunnedah, Corindai, sorry. We turn left here, so we miss the main street of Corindai, where Nan lives. So Nan lives on the other side. But we've got to head out left here to Gunnedah.
Turn left onto Camilleroy Highway, Lennox Street.
is also a heritage village. I've got cousins that live here, Glenn Crystal and Glenn's brother Ian. And the heritage village was brought over from all the gear at Willow Tree. When the Barwick sold the farm and closed it down, there's a heritage village with miniature trains, a little bridge you go over, a few houses and sheds full of all old colonial stuff.
Yeah.
And I believe there's some traction engines out there too. There's who would have thought at Lookout up on the right hand side. And I think the heritage village might be down this road here. It's been quite a few years. And I think my cousin lives down here somewhere. Crystal and Glenn. Hi guys. And Nan's on the other side of town. So this is Corindai, which we're bypassing and heading straight out to Gunnedah, 95 k's from here. Always fill up at Corindai before you head out. Diesel was $1.17. Alright, I better get to it. Catch us all later. That was the Gunnedah Straits, three massive long straits. We're coming into the town of Breeza. Tiny little thing. Breeza. Got a church, sacred sites, and some other things. I missed the sign. But there's a lot of indigenous sites around here, so... Oh look, here's a silo. Farms not coal. I'll get a photo of it. Let's take you up here, pan you over to the silo. There you go. Can't wait to see that puppy painted. Breeza, the town of Breeza, get your silos painted. All right, Gunnedah's 50 clicks from here. Here's Gunnedah. After those long straights, we're finally here. So it's 2 km to the centre, and then the silos up here on the left. We'll go there first, then we'll go find the camp and area. It should be coming up here. We'll be there in a sec. A long time later, we arrive. Here we are. We got UHF setups. Okay, we'll just park over here. Bums in, 45 degrees. Thank you.
Cause I'm an albatross.